Welcome, this is Ananda Suying, and this is this week's energetic oracle card reading for the week commencing the 26th of August 2024. So apologies that one was not posted last week, I was unwell. So this is this week's. So I'm using just two decks with the main three cards, as you can see in front, so the rose thread, Healing is Happening, and the Rose Garden, and they are from Rebecca Campbell's The Rose Oracle. Okay, so that's the first deck with the three main cards, which give us the sort of an idea of the flavor of the energy coming in for us this week. And the two at the top, the Lost Lands and the Blue Flame. Once again, it's from one of Rebecca Campbell's decks, and this is the Starseed Oracle. Okay, so let's have a look at these three, and I'm just going to lift the first one up. And this is the Rose Thread. Okay, and the words below are Inner Call, Soul-Led, the Mystic, Living Courageously. So I think it's, well, these cards are really brilliant because with the words that you have below the name of the card say, it says it all. It's an invitation to delve into yourself, to meet your inner self, to meet the inner wise one, to do all the work, the meditation, etc., going to sound baths, perhaps a gong bath, yoga nidra, if this is the method which suits you best to access your own inner voice, yeah, your subconscious, the spirit, the divine within, whatever you would call it, but answering that call, connecting and allowing yourself to be led by yourself. So it is really very much about sovereignty, empowerment, and courage, really letting go of all the all the self-destructive talk which plagues us quite a lot, and going beyond all of that, going beyond the culturally created self, I suppose, all the things that our parents have told us in order to survive in this world, our culture, but keeping those gifts, keeping the gifts of the ancestors, but trusting yourself and moving on, taking the first step towards being soul-led, your soul-led, not anyone else's, but yours. We're also reminded that healing is happening. It takes a lot of courage to really answer the call of the soul. And it's kind of weird because it's sometimes, you know, the healing or all the adjustment has to happen before we are happy to take, you know, we come to the position where we can take the first step. But I think we're being asked to just get on with it. And if you have a call, there is an invitation, there's been something niggling in the background, there's been something calling. Also, just to remind us all here that the end of the Mercury retrograde for England is going to be this Wednesday. So there's a lot of inner work still ongoing to even, you know, beyond Wednesday, of course, but this is the opportunity to go back on things that we may have worked on. Sometimes it's ancestral issues as well. But not to worry if we feel that the first steps, the baby steps, are causing a lot of discomfort for us. Don't worry, to be courageous, to allow ourselves to be vulnerable. If it is the time to ask for help, go for it. If it's the time to keep everything quiet for the time being, so that you allow it to ruminate and to start to adjust your energy, starts to engage the thought processes, the creative juices, which will help those steps really mean something, really work for you. So it may be time to ask for help. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's time to keep it secret for the moment and to let it percolate through a little bit more, but that healing is happening. I know we're not broken. No matter what, we are not broken. I trust the process. And it's safe to soften, so it's safe to be. It's saying it's safe to be vulnerable. So ask for help if you need it, especially if it's been tumultuous over the past few weeks and over the past few months and over the past few years, with lots of soul calling and soul knocking on the door going, well, what are you going to do? Okay, maybe it didn't seem to work when you first tried it. Perhaps it's important to try, keep trying, try again. Maybe you need to adjust the process. Maybe you need to adjust what you're doing or what you're offering or what you're trying or what you're learning. Maybe there's an adjustment so that the path is better and easier. Okay, so we're being encouraged to do this too. Rose garden. Innocence, forgiveness, be gentle with yourselves. I find that with a lot of healing, especially when it says you're not broken, here is the perfectionist and all the self-criticism, it's really, yeah, let it go. Just forgive yourself, let it go. If you've been judging yourself really harshly, just know that kind of creates the energy for it to be mirrored back, and it's a self-fulfilling prophecy. Then we get other people coming along and criticizing us. So it's time to release that. Let it go. Be in innocence. Be the child that we were when everything was, oh, such wonder, and you woke up every day wondering what you're gonna do now, or what you're gonna pretend to be, what we're gonna play at. And it's really reconnecting with that again, and to be gentle with ourselves. Yep, when we have a lot of healing, it's really important to give ourselves a bit of space and time, slow everything down, just take your time. There's no competition when it comes to this sort of work. There is absolutely no competition at all. You have to take the time. You have to make the effort. You have to set the time apart for your meditation or your time out going into nature. Whatever helps you to reconnect with yourself. And whatever gives you that space and that time, perhaps taking some time out from lots of social activities might be helpful. Yeah, so the lost lands. And just making sure you can see that. The lost lands. Soul memories and gifts. You've done this before. So whatever you're being called to, don't worry. All that information is in you. Perhaps your ancestors were doing it really successfully. Perhaps you in your past or future lives, etc. Or you have the capacity to draw all this information with your heart and mind into your body, and you find that actually it's really, really simple. Yeah? So just go for it. Perhaps the meditation or setting the intention that you remember these things so that the path is easier, that might be a good idea. And here you are, the blue flame. Oops, sorry, it's a bit wiggling it a bit. The blue flame, spontaneous awakening, activation, integration time. So absolutely wonderful. If you can find some time to go to sacred places or a place in nature that you really love, and spend a bit of time there. Perhaps if you love being in the mountains, to go and spend a bit of time there, and just sitting against your favorite tree or on your favorite rock, and just allowing yourself to dream, opening the mind, opening the heart, and just being a receiver to all, everything around you, nature, animals, they all know who and what they are. They don't have to be taught any of that. And I think this is a time where we're just being asked to remember, to receive, and to trust. And spontaneous awakening. So there's lots of energy around us, supporting us in this. Perhaps you may find that you have light bulb moments Perhaps you may find that all your chakras are spinning at the perfect speed, and you feel great, and you feel very creative, and that's wonderful. But also allow yourself to integrate all that you've learned, perhaps everything that your ancestors have learned, all their gifts as well, which accumulate or you may allow to accumulate and to materialize in you at this time. Okay, so I hope that's really useful. If you need any help, I do offer Reiki sessions and I do them remotely as well. I also run online live group Reiki sessions, and that's on a donation basis. And I run gong baths in London. And so I have one-to-one or group activities, and they're all an invitation for you to reconnect to yourself and to gain greater confidence in hearing your own voice. Okay, so thank you very much. If you found this useful, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe, and please do share it with your friends so that they can, if you found it useful, so that they can benefit and take heart with the reading as well. So love you all. Thanks for all your support, and have an amazing week. Bye for now.